We as humans have a really limited regenerative ability. Whether it's due to disease or injury, we just don't have the capacity to rebuild those tissues later in life. But what if we could? Zebrafish are incredibly similar to humans. The genomes are more than 80% identical. They're highly regenerative. Zebrafish can regenerate their spinal cords, their fins, and they can also regenerate portions of their heart. In adult humans, you have a small capacity to regenerate. In the example of a spinal cord injury, in a human, cells come in and try to wall off this damage to keep it from spreading. And they end up forming the scar, which on one hand is beneficial, but it ends up being very anti-growth. There's absolutely no option of regeneration past it, and that's where patients find themselves losing the ability to walk again. In zebrafish, none of those kind of negative phenomenon occur. You can have a very similar type of damage of the spinal cord after injury, but instead of forming this kind of really dense scar, cells actually create highways or bridges across the injury site. With these bridges being formed, these axons are allowed to cross back through the injury site, remake connections, and within about a month, it's able to swim again. The genes that are necessary to kind of drive these regenerative events, they exist in humans. But in humans, it's almost like they become dormant. If we can figure out how the cells are communicating or how they're making this pro-regenerative switch, we have the potential then to ask, is any of this harnessable in a human? Are there ways that we can manipulate the human nervous system to reinitiate this dormant regenerative gene that could aid in the regeneration after injury and disease? What we learn could lead us to understand something very important in human health and discover things that would allow us to rebuild our bodies.